And of course, for something that was made back in 2003, 4 out of 5 stars.
What?
Comments, comments.
Daily
comments.
Second place.
Daily What, was there nothing? Was there, like, a dude scratching his hairy ass for 5 minutes? Like, Slow Beef was doing that? Well, it's not quite as good as that. Mega Man, next
Let's
thing.
See. Most recently, April 11th of last year. Let's see. Missed a mark by a pretty far margin. Too frantic and a previously lamented no control guide. Seems like too much work for this as a payout. Good start, but needs a lot of work. 2.5 out of 5.
Good start? Good start!
And apparently he responded.
Whole different world.
Back in May 2003, it was a whole different world for computers and Flash for little to no programming schooling hobbyists. So, lots and lots of stuff missed the mark. Domain issues, breaking lines for the guide doesn't help any either, though probably gotta add that to my list of things to fix on the site.
That's not the only thing that needs fixed. Wait, 4 stars in 2013?
Yeah, May.
I'm on a pause button. Still 4 stars, but it only costs you a star to have pause, passwords, no auto charging.
Yeah, he gave it 4 stars despite. How about a pause button? Passwords, not auto charging.
Explanation of the controls.
How about a pause button? Passwords, not auto charging. Zoidberg, and
Four stars. I'm okay, but how do I even change my weapon at the cost? 5 stars. Okay, now I have to try rating. I seriously have to sort this by rating now.
You see some of the 5-star ones to see the comments on that.
Let's see. Good work, nice work. Well, is it good work or nice work? It all hinges on the bet. Where did you get the selection screen music from?
I think it's from the intro of Mega Man 4. You don't even know where you got your music from? You even fucking know where you... You make a Mega Man fan game without even knowing that...
Let's see. I got...
Wait,
I gotta
let's
find...
see. That comment was 2005. All amazing game.
What? I saw that.
Oh, this sounds interesting. Kareem from May 28th, 2007. Sweet! Except for one problem. A game with this length needs a save feature. Not only because the amount of time needed to play this game. I got all the way to the Mega Man next fight and my copy froze freak event. Thus, I lost all my data. The game is awesome, though, so I guess I'll just have to start again. 5 out of 5.
That's the only problem you come up with?
Clearly, I can find several more problems, and it's far beyond the save feature.
At least with the comments from 2003, I can understand them being, you know, this is cool, this is fine, because albeit, you know, Flash games were, you know, just kind of at their baby stages, but 2007?
Okay, let's go all the way to the bottom there. There is a bug with the game. The last guy was saying he couldn't start the levels, I think. Same here. It love to see the game, but it don't work. 0 out of 5. Any response? The game works fine.
No,
it
doesn't.
You aren't following the instructions. Use the arrow keys to select the stage, and then press shoot to select it. Sheesh. Yeah, you could do that. You forgot to mention clicking on the button with your mouse in order to do that. They'll still be stuck.
Clicking on the button and then
clicking on the button. The button.
The button on the bottom. Gotcha.
Follow the red.
You're not bad at this. You're not bad at this. I'm getting sick of making.
I'm not even interested about that, but rather the response. Dear God, man, we have to get you to a priest quick. Or at least an eye doctor. Apparently, you are either possessed by evil spirits and have no control over your hands, or you can't see the big, large title that clearly says Mega Man Next - the game. Get help before it's too late. You don't want to end up like that chick in The Exorcist. Excuse me?
Yeah. P.S. I've read that the FBI uses for training.
Okay, now we're starting to get into different things.
You've thoroughly defiled the name.
Oh, here's something. Hopefully, it'll be good. The Zergling from June 5th of 2003. Gay. The game sucked when you die in a level. Like, say you go to the next part of the level. When you die, you start all the way from the beginning. That makes it so terrible. I'm giving it a 1. 1.5 out of 5.
Okay, the levels are a quarter the size of a normal Mega Man level.
They sure don't feel like it.
In a normal Mega Man game. If they don't do it, why should I? Why the hell should I restart you at the section you died on? You were warned several times that this game is hard. I'm sorry. You don't have the skills to play it. I recommend going back and playing the genuine games. You'll fare much better there.
First of all, they felt like they were as long as the original Mega Man stages. Second of all, get good is not a good response.
Not really.
That's not an answer, you chat. That's fucking game facts. Thread answers, for Christ's sake.
I thought that was borderline smog on.
Oh, yeah. You know what? Let's not. That goes without saying. How do you beat?
Okay, yeah,
this comment.
Do
Let
that.
Me read this. How do you beat this game? This game is near impossible. I beat it like 4 of the bosses using my regular weapon. Getting the punch is useful to getting 2 bosses, though. No matter how hard I try, Mirror Man is impossible to kill. Has got his shield up 80% of the time, and the 20% of the time has got it down. Lasts for like 0.5 of a second to a second. I'm a website. 2 stars out of 5. I'm Purple Cobras.
I'm done. I'm sorry.
Glitchy little piece of shit. I love the graphics, I love the music, and the original new bosses, but this is far too glitchy, far too unbalanced, and completely unplayable. It's garbage. Retool it, take better care of the project, and maybe it might pass as, quote, decent, unquote.
2 out of 5. Responses.
First, I gotta read this. It's the response. Question, man. You're not listing any glitches, parts that are unbalanced. Thus, it doesn't help me figure out why you think it's unplayable. This is like Metroid Beginnings. What do I have to point out? Personally, me and my friends have a ball playing it, as do numerous others on this site. Who the fuck places an S-bot? Who the fuck thought the FBI used that thing for training? Who the fuck? Who does it? It's been garbage. I think Twitch Action Games probably your cup of tea. I recomment Connect 4 or Crossword Puzzle. They have a nice slow pace and won't try to chew your face off.
Excuse me?
Dickhead! Even Mega Man games aren't like the fuck! What is wrong with what a jackass response? I'm sorry, I just...
Wow.
Okay.
You need to be a little more detailed here. I'm not exactly saying what sucks or so it can be addressed. There's just so many...
Wait, go down.
Yes, this one we have to talk about.
Okay, then. Would you?
Let's see. Wait. I think everyone is being a bit too kind to rate this game. Come on, look at this game. It's a disgrace. I give huge credit to the programmer for writing such complex code because Flash programming is hard. But really, the creator got lazy when it came to the drawing and animation. Flash have the highest quality graphics, and if you can't draw that, it's pretty good. So why you use crappy pixelated sprites? Maybe it's easier, but it looks like bullshit. Sorry for the profanity, but I can't stand... Perfectly great programming wasted on such shitty display. Indeed, it's a shame.
2.5 stars. People found that helpful.
Here's the good part of that comment. 2003. Someone in 2003 even wouldn't put up this bullshit.
Yeah.
So, you know, with some small hope. There was some hope. A decent review, but flawed. You're going to review the review?
Oh my god, look
good
at this.
Lord. Did you write a fucking essay to this?
I should have reviewed the game, for Christ's sake, instead of the fucking...
Okay.
Well, you gotta read the whole thing. You gotta read the whole damn thing.
God.
Either that or link to space and something.
I thought people defending Depression Quest were insane.
The game should, and what I, as in me, the creator, wanted it to have. There's Fallout 22, please don't confuse them. Let me go into a little more detail for you
crystal
to make this crystal clear to you. Lazy for my hand drawings, yes, there's no problem admitting that. I told everyone I put next to effort in these drawings, save the one of Mega Man next. Oh, I guess spoilers as a boss, or whatever you didn't say. The game is supposed to look a lot like a NES, not exactly. As such, drawing everything in Flash's vector graphics is out of the question! I'll repeat for you, out of the question! If using Flash-based bitmap bitmap functions rights didn't appeal to me.
Once again, repeating, out of the question! Have I mentioned enough times with out of the question? I don't think so.
Got it memorized. The graphics are done in pixels because they are the sprites used in the original NES games. How are you going to tell me to draw them by hand in Flash, which would totally be the purpose of the net?
Okay, NES-like clearly MS Paint, this guy doesn't understand the difference between what he was talking about, the background images, some of the bosses you go against, and basically the whole layout, not necessarily Mega Man himself. And the creator can't even tell the difference between that.
That's about the only thing that was taken exactly from the NES game, so honestly. FYI, that means for your information, no Flash does not have the highest quality graphics. You just double negative that, I hope you know. So Flash does. Concession! Hey, congratulations, MGTR. Okay, we'll give you this one. It can do damn good, but the cost for a super high-quality vector graphic done in Flash is it draws slower than an 8-bit sprite does any day of the week.
Oh, God, repeating it again.
Any day
Jesus
of the week.
Christ.
Fuck.
Seriously, this is a long-ass rebuttal.
I think what you're looking for is the drawback.
Yeah.
Anyway, there was no cutting corners in this when I was drawing. Almost 100.
Drawing what? You basically took out MS Paint. You made a bunch of rocks different colors that you probably took from some other websites, copied and pasted it onto rocks, and then tried to smooth it out, make it look good. And then you made a level design based on that, and then you threw in a bunch of sprites that whatever fucking sued you that week, depending on the math. Ego Titus that you drank up that week. Seriously.
Go ahead.
Man, I mean, you know, Sinister Figure took this a lot better, you know?
A little. Maybe not a lot, but a little.
He at least played through the fucking game, and he admitted it wasn't that great, but at the same time, he was willing to work on the damn thing.
And you know, the 100 stages plus backgrounds. Are you shitting me? I don't think so. There's 100 fucking stages and backgrounds in this. I don't even think there's 10. And making them interactive or making up over 10 bosses and animating them plus deck. Maybe he meant to say 10 in typo, but I don't know.
You should watch your tongue.
Watch your tongue more before saying some retarded shit like being lazy. You can't say that. Watch your tongue, shithead. That doesn't match.
You know that guy that pretty much made the Lewis Prower game? That guy put far more effort into that than this guy ever did.
Especially since I'm not charging a penny to play this. Free doesn't justify shit. That is not a justification. It's not. I mean, yes, there are some people that I can understand them being. Well, I'm just making it for YouTube. That means I'm not gonna exactly put high quality everything. But at least put some in. Pretend like you give a damn. Just pretend like it matters to you. Whatever. You're gonna bother to create it, you know. Go back.
I mean,
and
seriously, some games have basically been made with a budget of nothing. I mean, Christ. I mean, I could think of some fucking visual novels that were very appealing to read. Yeah, they didn't have any Ebro content, but they were really well drawn, and yeah, they did borrow, you know, material and shit, but, you know, they put all the work into the writing, and the writing was great.
Free,
and guess what?
You can make it free of quality, for crying out loud.
Yeah, as in the guy probably, the people that read it, you know, they were like, hey, this is good shit. And here, you're not, you worked on a game that back in those days, I'm not going to deny, Flash was a serious motherfucking piece of shit. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to deny that one. It was a piece of fucking shit. Because, trust me, I couldn't get anything to work on that fucking thing if I tried. Nowadays, it's a lot easier, but, you know, the fact that you have this, like, you didn't address the problems, you didn't try to update the game up till now, in order to, you know, I mean, if it was like this back then, you should at least, you know, while you, you know, got done, you should have been updating it constantly, trying to make it better and better. But nowadays, I mean, it didn't age well at all.
Oh, yes, number six, one, my absolute favorite.
Number six. Go back and play the NES Mega games before you start bashing the sprites. If you don't appreciate NES games, then you shouldn't have played this from the get-go.
That's look besides yourself, the point!
Do you understand the gameplay, you fucking moron?
That's it! That's the only thing you should have given to
the rest
of the
game. In fact,
let's
look at the stage designs here.
Even the bullets weren't the lemons from the NES games. You can't even
let's
say that.
Let's look at the stage designs from them. You go from one point to another, and then you go to another section, one point to another. That doesn't scream Mega Man gameplay to me.
Because around an area to get to more.
At least every stage in a Mega Man game has at least a gimmick or two that defines it, or at least a theme. Your stages seem to lack a theme. More like a theme of schizophrenia, but...
Oh, and this is going to be great. File size. Look at the damn file size, Jughead.
Didn't you just tell us earlier to watch our tongue? Look who's talking?
Oh, are we suddenly reading Archie comics or something? What the hell? If I added more frames, animation, higher quality graphics, you wouldn't have played this because it wouldn't have... Oh, first he says wouldn't have, then he says wouldn't have. Do you know the proper expression then? Why are you doing it? Have been able to upload it. Wouldn't have been able to be uploaded, Nimrod. There's more to consider than just how pretty it is. If you had shit for brains, you realize that we're saying anything. Graphics don't make the game, but it means at least not be an eyesore. We're asking great,
exactly.
It's just acceptable. That's what we're asking.
I mean, good example of decent graphics in a Mega Man-based game? Street Fighter Cross Mega Man. Simple, easy, but they worked. And the level design was pretty coherent for the most part, and it worked fine. The only problem was I found the bosses were slightly incoherent, albeit. But that was about it.
As for sprites being an easy way out is entirely opinion. I read the sentence twice. I'm lost. What the hell did he say? Is that English?
I don't fucking know.
Some people can draw sprites faster. Others can hand draw Some people can draw sprites.
Dude, I've made personal sprites. It's not fucking hard.
Versus draw, he uses hand draw. What's the previous? What kind of drawing is the first?
What's the difference, if any?
What kind of drawing is the not hand draw? Okay, what's not hand draw then? M is paint draw, I guess. I don't know what specify here. You're not making. I happen to be one of the sprite kind of people, and I prefer raster graphics to vector. When I say it's styled quote like unquote a NES game, then that means styled quote like unquote a NES game, dipshit. you know, when you emphasize and shout something in air,
I can see the comment here.
Fresher on what the dude was talking about.
Okay, he might have had some language issues, but otherwise, he basically said from the get-go, "I'm gonna be honest." So, why are you giving him this much shit for being honest with him?
Like a fair warning, jeez. Don't try to tell me anything. Don't try to tell me anything otherwise after I told you what my goal was with the graphics.
Don't even try to muddle the situation with your fancy mathematics and all that nonsense.
Fancy mathematics. If you don't like sprites, fine. You don't like graphics, fine. Don't tell me I should use vector graphics, because if I did, then I would have. You should have made a good Flash game, but you didn't. It's not impossible.
You made an awful
one. The only thing that's a shame is I can't fully express how oblivious and stupid you seem to me right now for saying some dumb shit like that. Hopefully you'll read this, figure out the error of your ways. Maybe I'll see a more Tales review from you instead of this whiny crybaby shit. Look who's talking!
Look who's talking!
What? How can we have such an obvious, blatant disconnect? How does that happen? Your comment was like 10, your response was like 10 times longer than the original comment, and he's the one. What? I shouldn't assume gender, but I'm just saying, either way, what? Welcome to Newgrounds, I guess.
So, yeah,
fuck.
Does anyone feel like if you watch an e-hug right now, even though it's past its time and probably doesn't matter, but I feel like giving that person an e-hug right now because he didn't deserve that much crap.
I want a thumbs up for Finder's View Extremely Helpful for that bullshit. Yeah, it's a good thing you have the creator in here, because if this is what we have to listen to...
Well... I almost wish
that was an actual thing. You know, people can find this review helpful, not helpful, or indifferent. Is there a thing that can say make creator comment replies rate them as helpful, not helpful, maybe not that useful, or crazy?
Oh dear, Mobius has an image for the moment. I think. Okay. My Skype almost broke on me. I'm sorry. It scared the shit out of me. It tried to close the damn window on me. I'm so sorry. Try it again.
Skype is way
pretty much. I haven't even updated it in the longest of times. Yeah. Already it's acting like how it shouldn't.
Oh yeah, I don't want the news to update, so I keep refusing to recognize that. Yeah, I like that. Movie's 10 out of 10. The fuck is this shit?
In fact, yeah, just to emphasize that, so everyone else.
Actually, I got another one. I got another one right here too.
Oh boy.
And oddly, this was in the actual game of Drakengard 3. That pretty much represents my feelings about this.
I remember this. Yeah.
Or should I show this one right here too? This audio has been deemed inappropriate for human consumption. Please stand by. Yes, it was.
All I'm gonna say is that I don't even care this has gone over 15 minutes. It was worth it. For this one, offense, GM. I'm sure he's. It's been 10 years since that comment. So maybe by now he's better able to handle this sort of.
Well, let's
and
let's
if you're friends with
this...
GM, that's a bit. This comment's terrible.
Let's keep this in mind. Let's go back to rating again by this. So I wonder if there is someone who actually tried taking this seriously a bit.
Well, I only got one.
You get commented on, damn.
And if the guy still is that way, I only got one response to him, and it's just this right here.
This one to do it. There's like, I just save it straight out, geez. Whoa, too much coding to make a second heat character. I was thinking about letting Proto Man be like a second costume. Still more than I was willing to do for free. Try the strategy guide I made for it. Effort. Not this time out. Really, Skype? 7 minutes for a freaking image? Typical Skype. Well, you know, if you get it faster, maybe you can just show it that way through some freaking screen share or whatever.
It's basically Spoonie just going, no! No! No!
He had a Steve Carell moment.
He was mimicking Daniel Bryan from Dead AUE.
Oh, okay. Because that's The Office, but yeah.
Actually, this... Yeah, they will not receive that file because it takes too long. Actually, this one would be actually more understandable of what I generally think of the ROM hack.
Okay, 3 kilobytes. There's no way Skype's gonna fuck up.
Yeah,
2 hours.
Just how you say
no
that.
Way you're gonna fuck this up, right? No way you're gonna fuck this up. You didn't see that. Put on boots, put on life vest, man the lifeboat. BS Peter, nice. Var nice. I definitely 10 out of 10.
Yep, 10 out of 10. Brown thumbs! Up his ass!
Loading.
Yeah.
But the fact that we're actually taking this seriously is kind of sad. If he did legitimately get better, I would like to see if maybe he did any other Flash games beyond this.
He actually did do a lot more Flash games.
I'm wondering about that Mega Man X. Sorry, I just gotta wonder.
But yeah.
Or the Flash game will inspire me to do this.
Let's see all the kind of stuff that he did. From games. Made games as recently as 2009.
And I see that Mega Man, so that doesn't fill me with a lot of confidence.
Do you want to know what the next game underneath that is?
Mega Man X.
Mega Woman or something?
You're not ready for
this. Can't tell what the hell that is. Probably.
No, I don't know!
I had a spike moment. I'm sorry. No!
Take this. My money and all my soul.
Oh yes, I should show you this stupid one, because I thought this was just pure stupid.
And prepares to stop Wily again. Mega Man next intro.
Press down to fall early.
If it seems slow, use low quality.
I'm pressing down. Your intro. I'm even ducking. It's not working.
Your 2024 20XX. Excuse me while I say 20XX. Just saying.
In
fact, I'm even going to try and get the sound going for this one. Because I think it's purely stupid, but it has to be emphasized.
Really, really have to complete it. Why don't you want to do it?
Do,
Monsteropolis wasn't established until Mega Man 2.
Even the fucking fart board got tired of it.
Philip J. Cashew. That's what I say with that image. Philip J. Cashew. End of story, game.
And you know what I'm hearing in the background? For this? Ken's from Street Fighter 2.
What? Huh?
How does this revolve around Mega Man?
Only connection is Capcom, and that feels kind of tenuous. And why are we going into the history of the Mega Man here? Why do we need a long fucking text scroll like this? This is not Star Wars. This is not fucking... We don't need... What?
And just when you think it's done... finally we get... God damn it.
What, is he going to go all the way up to Mega Man, like... He's gonna start picking up Mega Man games at this point, like Mega Man 16.
And then it says, like, this is happening, like, a year or something after the events of 8, which is clearly not true. As we saw from Mega Man Next, yeah.
I don't think that's how... Held by a Mr. X. That's a great name, by the way. I would trust somebody named Mr. X. My best friend called me Cash. Only the world breathes a sigh of relief. Well, they weren't looking at this Flash game, obviously. Fuck, does this ever end? We're still on the frames. We're still 50-something minutes here. Fuck me.
Also, it was four of them activated automatically. The other four, Dr. Wily, it was only later. Cool.
Yeah, jeez.
This seems to go on forever.
It does.
Shit.
It does.
Oh. Oh my god. I could be finishing up Emmy's story in Katawa Shoujo by then.
Well, I think it was really...
Fuck.
When speaking of visual novels, say what you will about Katawa's shoujo, I'm willing to give it far more credit when compared to Sakura Spirit.
Although he's gonna say he's a Sentinel, he now has a soul. Then Mega Man 8 happens and it goes to shit. What do you have to fight this? Bring you to the... Shut the fuck up. Forget him. That is not getting a soul. That's getting lame.
If anything, Katawa Shoujo is a good introductory visual novel.
Besides, in Katawa really Shoujo, you have multiple options that have various different outcomes of that. Sakura Spirit, one option. Either way, doesn't change the story whatsoever.
Holy fuck, why did you think this was a good idea?
It could be worse, it could be like this.
Just end it already! God, you know, you could have had a one-sentence text blurb about each game if you really want to do this. It was just one or two sentences, so you need to go on and on and on. You're not telling us! God damn!
Yeah, the one thing we should have done from the beginning... I'm sorry. I pressed the wrong button. Hold on. I pressed the wrong button.
Now we gotta start the game all over again.
There. Oh, and whatever you're trying to send through Skype, Mobius is not one to send for some reason. Oh, wait. As soon as I said something.
Yeah. Take this. My love, my anger, and all of my money.
Bury me with my
money. I still have that
money.
One. And I love that picture.
Yeah. Let me see. So application for legal operation program will be shut down. Problem persists. Please contact the program vendor.
It's the universal century. This still happens.
Kate's you
it's
bastard.
Poor Avro.
This is my first game and uploaded here. I try to make it look a lot like a Nintendo game. Capcom for making such a good game in the first place. Don't. Hater votes and ass kissers don't help anybody. Yeah. Well, too late.
Well, you don't want to know whose fault it really is? It's a goddamn fascist feminist media! Ah! Shut up, Captain.
Social justice, am I right, guys? Anyway.
Oh, God. Oh, man. That still makes me laugh. I don't play video games, but video games are about shooting people and stuff. And I get death threats, even though they've been proven not to be true. I send them to myself.
Oh, that would be the greatest breakthrough of all that if it turns out she was actually doing that too, just to get a fake to gain sympathy, you know?
That's actually partially true. I can imagine that.
Take your own fucking death threats.
Well, yeah.
Take
your
own death.
Do it Vince McMahon style.
Fuck, faking your death is one thing. Faking your own death threats, that would be new to me.
Wouldn't surprise me.
That's saying the world of so much is.
There is no strong female characters in video games. What? You did not just say that.
Samus Aran, let's just pretend another arm never happened. Samus Aran never existed.
So Peach is not a strong character, nor is Rosalina.
I guess. Zelda, she's willing to stand up and especially Hyrule Warriors now.
Zelda.
What about her main
Wind
guardian,
Waker,
Impa?
Spirit Tracks.
Oh, fuck yes, Impa, yeah.
Midna.
Oh, Jesus, Midna, yes.
Let's see, Saria.
Hell, Noboru is the one person in race smart enough to use her brain and say, oh, Ganon's evil, let's not follow this bastard.
Exactly.
She was only one, but she was one of them.
Let's see, the whole entire cast of Senran Kagura, yeah, surprise, surprise, they're all actually strong, well-developed characters. I'm not talking about their bodies, Jesus Christ!
They also want to argue that the existence of Ganondorf is racist. They say he's black.
Well, actually, I was thinking he was more of Arab, but okay.
That's what they wanted to argue, that he's black. And I'm gonna say, time out. Let's call this over. Are you saying Gerudos are a human race? These are more like elves. The people that are in Hyrule, the human ones, are more like elves, not human beings. It's a bit of a different story.
Now it's not going out of my head when I see Beast Ganon. All I'm going to hear is the song, I'm Black, yo!
God damn it.
See what you've done. And you know what kills me most? This whole Ganondorf is Black thing came from something sponsored, at least apparently anyway, sponsored by PBS. I wanted to die.
I mean, what about all the strong female characters in Final Fantasy, Lara Croft, and are there storytelling? Most of the Dragon Quest females? Did I mention the main female protagonist of fucking Fantasy Star 1? Who fought an evil god on her fucking own. Oh, but I guess that don't count because she wasn't obviously in a shooter or things or games that tear people's heads off. Oh, no.
let's not, you know, there was no such thing as like Jill Valentine or Claire Redfield or whatever.
Or better yet, Bea fucking Netta. You want to know what the irony to Bayonetta is, despite all her stripperific routine is? She was drawn and made by a woman!
So just... What
figure
happened?
That shit out!
Yeah, I appreciate the distance low clap. 10 out of 10. God damn it.
I mean, come on. I mean, and then you're going to say that in anime? Bullshit!
I just don't understand what... So, yeah, I'm definitely not in the mood for playing the harder difficulties. So, yeah, do we want to end this part and I could show you the video where the creator does finish the game?
That ought to be fun.
Yes, you know what?
Now
yes.
We probably got some Sarkeesian feminists riled up, so... Let's
that was an hour six.
Our YouTube channel is down in the links below, or your death threats, which we invite.
I think when people subscribe to one of my friends on YouTube, Scratch Point, he would love this little conversation right here. He can't stand any of that.
I mean, seriously, what happened to just playing a fucking video game?
Yeah, what happened to that? This is all a fantasy world. Why does it have to mirror the real world? The entire point is that it's not.
Why does it have to be some political message? Really? I mean, if the game portrays a political message of sorts, that's one thing. But when you're projecting things that onto the game that don't make really much sense or work at all,
They want to do is censor the right to artistic freedom and artistic expression.
Yeah.
If there was a creator imagines the protagonist is white, they're white. It's not racism. That's just what they wanted for their story. I mean, it's not inherently racism anyway. It's just...
It's just that the thing is, they want the every guy.
If they imagine the protagonist white or female and dressed in a way that might be attractive, it's their prerogative. It doesn't automatically mean it's sexism or racism or whatever. I mean, goddamn.
I mean, seriously, the producer of Senran Kagura, he specifically has all the girls done like that because he loves boobs. At least he's honest.
And you know, honestly, if it bothers you, here's the best solution. Don't fucking scream about it. Just don't play it. Find something else.
This is easy as you're
yeah, exactly. What you, I mean, you don't have way. To.
Nothing more than that.
That's what you just walk.
I mean, you don't have to sit down and, you know, play Criminal Girls Invite Only or Senran Kagura. You can go play something nice or, you know, something that's more your thing. You don't have to make a big outburst and, you know, direct all your hatred towards the people that play it. I mean, you're kind of projecting them the wrong way. Oh, by the way, males get the same harassment as females do online. Yeah.
Oh, but that
sure.
doesn't exist. It's not, you know what the argument I heard was? It's not sexism if it's directed at a male.
Huge bullshit.
Amounts of bullshit there.
I mean, seriously.
The definition. The dictionary definition does not specify a gender. It really doesn't. It doesn't
it's more common with females, but the thing is, it happens on both sides, and the thing is, they won't hear the other side.
It doesn't change the definition. It just doesn't. So it's like, anyway, the world of gaming is vast. You can find something that you like. Just put a little effort into it. If it's not your thing, go a different direction. Wow, that was difficult. It's like YouTube videos. You know, leave one comment and then walk. Go find somebody else to watch. It's not that hard.
I mean, it's one thing if you say that you hate the game, and because maybe it, you know, maybe it just doesn't appeal to you, or it just grosses you out. That's fine.
Personal opinion's fine.
You know, to the point that you're projecting like all these fucking messages and all that shit. I don't know where you're coming from on that.
Finally glad to get that rant right into a public video. I'm out of time. I got the man. Okay, yeah, yeah. An hour 10. This is definitely the ranty video of Mega Man Madness.
This is why we don't get together very often.
Exactly.
Because we never stop.
It never ends. This is the rant that does it. And Charlie Horse! Don't care.
We will never stop. And we can't sing a tune to save our lives for the very day we figure we can find you with this informational message that you could pass on, or you could tell us to fuck off on.
Sing along, but I just don't have the energy to keep up with it.
You were the one that was playing, so you have every right to say, no, fuck it, I'm done.
Yeah.
Good night, and watch out for MS Paint Bass. I'm not gonna call him Bass. I'm not gonna call him Bass. He's Bass because it's fucking next. He's Bass. I bet this was voice acted. It would have been Bass just because.
My name is.
It would have been Bass and Dr. Willy.
You mean Dr. Wiley?
Either Willy or Wiley.
I guess that would explain the mustache. Despite us calling him a German bastard, he's actually French. Our apologies.
French, mais oui.
Undole!
Now we're just being culturally.
Yeah, all of a sudden I'm just pulling out a random Highlanders reference. What the hell's wrong with you Spaniards? I'm not Spaniard, I'm Egyptian. Well said, Sean Connery. That's the best way to describe it.
Okay, now it's time for me to hold up a card that has some negative connotation of some race or something on it. I can't even say it because, well, I can't because I don't want to because I'm not that kind of person. Okay, and that was the joke.
Oh, it's even better. Just one last thing for me. I'm so sorry. It's even better when these people accuse all video game protagonists are white, even the ones that come from Japan, where I'm pretty sure they don't refer to themselves as white. So that still doesn't work.
It's an artistic choice.
It really is. There's nothing wrong with that. It's like, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. You don't censor artistic expression, for crying out loud. Anyway, I don't want to get back in. I'm good. I'm done.
Yeah.
Good.
We'll see you then.
Goodbye, folks. I guess. In Mega Man March Madness. Indeed. This is the madness of it.